Hey there, everyone. This is Pork Pants. I'm taking a quick look at the new game, Waking Violet. It's due for release on June 29th for $4.99 in the North American eShop. I'll try to check out other eShops and find that pricing when I write up my little mini review. I got a early review copy from Mixed Bag Games. This game was, in fact, produced by Mixed Bag, and it was developed by Marco Mastropaolo. I apologize for the pronunciation if it's wrong. But Waking Violet is a top-down puzzler. It's got 42 different levels. You essentially play as a little girl that is stuck in a dream, and you find clues in each of the little puzzles to what is going on, why you're trapped in this world. This game's got some pretty cool mechanics. Sort of traditional puzzle type stuff, moving boxes, activating switches, doors. But it's got some other neat things. It's got a time rewind system, so if you mess up, you don't have to start the whole level over again. You can rewind a little bit and try something different. It's got a pretty cool magic system. I got a couple of spells pretty early. I've played the game for probably about an hour and a half to 2 hours, played through the first set of levels. And I'm going to just go through some of the introduction and some of the first levels here to show you guys what the game is like, and we'll talk about what's going on a little bit. All right, so I will load up a new game here just to show you guys the intro. This is the main character, Violet. She's got her signature, I guess, fox hat. So this is sort of a tutorial level. You can see you get this little overview. All right. One thing that I found a little hard to get used to was the movement. You sort of just wobble and walk. It's got this grid-based system, but like I said, you can sort of walk on half grids, which is a little getting used to. These yellow blocks here. These are the ones that you can push around. If you push them into water, it can form a bridge. It's obviously a pretty easy puzzle here. You can only push, you cannot pull, so you need to plan your moves out beforehand. So part of the level here, there should be a little tutorial pop-up. It says the alarm clock will unlock time on this level, activating portals and enemies. So every level you have to hit the alarm clock, and then this little purple guy here will turn into a portal, and that's how you end the level. So you can see this gray dude down here. He will actually become active when you hit this, so we'll just, let him do his thing. See? Portal's open. Guy's active. He is pretty quick, so you're not going to outrun him. As you can see, we died. It says press L to undo your last move. So it takes you back to your last move, and if you hold down L, you can actually rewind. So I'm actually going backwards now. So obviously part of finishing the puzzle is that you want to prevent these guys from chasing you, so we'll just block them off. See, now he's stuck in there. Like I said, if that was wrong, we can go backwards. So I really do like the music in the game. It's very well done. It's not overpowering. So this is sort of the first, I guess, hub world. As you can see, there's a little bit of puzzling on getting past some of these blocks and stuff, but we're going to go through a few of these levels. I don't want to go through too many and spoil them for you guys. Well, There we go. I said sometimes the movement's a little tricky. You have to sort of line it up correctly. So this is another obstacle. These lightning orbs will actually just zap you if you walk in front of them. But one good thing is this block, as you can see, is in the middle, so it's actually blocking both of the orbs. The other thing too is we have these switches. They look like flowers. That's a switch. So this switch actually causes fire to shoot out. I think I actually better rewind here. There we go. So what we're gonna do? Oh. See, I pushed the block too far, so we'll just rewind. We're going to activate this, then I think we're going to take out that dude up there. So he's going to kind of wander around a little bit. And then you can use this to blow up the block. And we will continue on our way. You can see up in the top right corner is sort of a magic potion icon. That'll fill up... I'm going to try and find the level where that comes into play. You get a couple different magic skills. Let's go into this one. You can't go past it yet, so... Yeah, here we go. So as you can see, you have to be careful of the lightning. So we'll do block the lightning. We'll get this potion. So now you have 25 energy. I think we'll actually make sure that this guy gets blocked off. Might as well just seal them in, right? And these papers here, this scroll, I'm not going to go through the text. I'll let you guys read that when you play. But this is, you can see now on the bottom right there, we've got the little fire, costs 25 energy. So we just activate that by hitting the B button. I forgot it doesn't fire, so. I have to go up here and fire it. So there we go. We can do it 3 more times. So we'll probably have to just blow up 3 and then push that. And there we go. We'll do, one more level here. So this one shows off, again, another sort of common mechanic. These are actually switches. And as you can probably guess, you need to get blocks on all 4 switches to activate them. I did this wrong. Yeah, I did. Let's see, instead of resetting the whole level, which might actually be quicker, you could just rewind to a spot where you feel like you can. I'm actually going to fix that one. Just little things like this. Now we can see here, this gate is blocked. So, as you see here, this switch works backwards. When it's down, the door is closed. Now, the first time I did this, I was like, oh yeah, I'll get the clock, and then I got stuck, I couldn't do anything. So, in general, it's best to pick up the potions first. Like I said, I want to show about 10 minutes of gameplay, and I think we're at about 11 minutes right now. And that was the first, you know, handful of levels. You can actually go back into any level and try them again if you want. There is another magic mechanic in here that lets you walk on water, so I imagine in later levels there'll be a lot of time-based water elements. Overall, I think this game is a lot of fun if you're into puzzler type games. These levels are pretty simple, but like I said, with 42 different levels, it looks like it's going to be, you know, significantly more challenging as the game progresses. And like I said, the price point is great, $5 in North America. Like I said, in about an hour and a half, I think my other save file was just under 15% done. So, you know, once you know what to do, you probably look at 4 or 5, maybe 6 hours of gameplay, depending how hard the final levels are. So, I definitely recommend that you check out this game from Mixbag. It will be available on the Nintendo eShop later this week on June 29th. Again, $4.99 in North America. I will be writing up a sort of mini review as well to get some of my thoughts down about this game, and I really do look forward to playing this some more and, you know, finishing it, and, you know, I'll definitely be available to answer any questions if you guys have any other questions about the game. Thanks for watching, and I definitely hope you check out the game.